Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hi everyone again, and today I am here with the class 9 economics chapter number 1, the story of Palanpur. So children, moving further, we have to start this chapter, the story of Palanpur. Why we have taken this topic? Why the name of the chapter is Palanpur? Because this is a name of a village, and we have taken this story of the village, and it is being an example. It is given as an example how a small village, which is self-sufficient and economically sustainable within the village only, and it does not depend on the outer connection with the villages or the big cities, because everything in the village is present, and how people make use of their things and resources and how the things are fully sustainable, that they don't have to depend on the other outcomes or sources, because everything they have made by themselves and everything is present in the. So this village is economically very much in good state and economically stable also. So we will be not going to the chapter wise things. I will be only giving you the important details and topic about this chapter, what are the necessary things. So I will be discussing the theme is production, means the main thing is that economically dependent village means that the village has its own production areas. So main thing that we will talking about at first is the production area. So what are the things, how the village is economically dependent on the things they have only within the village only. So resources combined to produce goods and services. So the village is having fully sustainable resources within the village only, so by which they use the resources in a very good manner, in a very proper manner, planned manner. So the goods they produce within these resources only, and these goods and services are supplied in their village and outside the village also, because of the help of the resources that they are having in the village only. Now the second point, Palanpur, the name of the village, is well connected to the neighboring cities, that is Rajganj and Shahapur. So this Palanpur village, which is very small, is well connected. Well connected, we come to know that the roads are in a very good condition. It is the transport facility is good. It is easy to travel and move from Palanpur to the cities also. So there is good connection of roads and transport. So this village is well connected to the nearby neighboring cities, small cities, that is Rajganj and Shahapur. Next point is 450 families are there. 450 families are living in the village, in which what we have 80 upper caste families. So in the total population of the village is 450 families. 450 families are there in the village, and among that 80 upper caste people are living, families are living, those who are living in the large houses, and we can call it pakka houses, means cemented well built houses, brick and all, and they are called pakka houses or well built houses. Upper class people, families are having, because they are rich, so they are having so many facilities, and they are upper caste also. The same contrast, we have 1/3 of the population, that is scheduled caste or scheduled tribe. They are not upper class, they are lower class. So they are living in a small houses and in a corner of the village, not in the scattered all over the village, but they are living at the corner of the one side of the village in a their proper community or locality, and they live in a small house that is made up of mud and straw, that we can take say kacha house or a hut likely, which is made up of mud and straw. And they are, because they are scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, they are poor, they are not having good job opportunities, and they have to live in very small houses that are at the corner of the villages. Now the village Palanpur has electricity connection. The village of the Palanpur has good electricity connection. That is why they can run their machinery, household work they are doing, small industry in the their houses they are running or small factories they are having. So good supply of electricity helps them a lot and their homes also. Now they have two schools within the village also, which is very good. They don't have to move outside and send their children for to study. The village is having itself two good school where the children can go for their study. And they have two hospitals also. Medical care facilities, healthcare facilities are also present within the village, in which we have two hospital. One is government hospital and one is private hospital. So the people can choose if they want to spend more, they can go to the private, the upper class or the rich people, and government hospital for the lower class or the poor people. So the school, colleges, electricity resources are all present in the village, and the population, I have told you, 450 families are living, in which upper and the lower caste people are there. So these are the theme of production, or the why the production, what is happening. Okay, so in the first part, I just told you that what were the criteria, what were the things that were all present in the village itself, what were the resources that were present, and how were it was fully sustainable village, how the village was now independent. And now the first theme was our production. So what are the factors of production that the village has and how they are following? Okay, so production is the fundamental key to success for any city, state or country. So production is very necessary. Production can be farming or non-farming. A village can be farming or engaged in farming activity or non-farming activity, because our primary activity is like farming, agriculture or related to agro-based industry. So the primary activity is farming or non-farming activity. The village can be, people can be engaged in both the types of activity. Now secondly, aim to get goods and services. Now the production aim is to get the goods and the services what they are working for, these activities they are doing. Now factor of production, now what are the factor responsible for the production, what are the factors needed for a better production, that we will go by this. First of all, for the factor of production, we need land. First of all, we need a piece of land to start our work, like a farming or non-farming activity. Piece of land we want, but it is a limited production. Limited production means it is limited, it cannot grow, it cannot increase, and it is very scarce also. Suppose there are four brothers in a family, so if a certain piece of land is divided among themselves, then they would be receiving a very small piece of land. So land cannot increase, but it can be divided to certain parts. So land is a first factor of the production. Okay, that does not increase with time. Then second is labor. Labor we can have manual or educated. The laborers we can have, those who can do manual means physical work in the fields or in the industries. Or we have educated one, those who are skilled, they have knowledge to do certain works for the production. Then the most important thing, factor of production, is the physical capital. Physical capital means it can be money, it can be knowledge, skill or experience. So fixed use of many years. So it can be used, the money can be used for the fixed year, for many years, coming years, and can gain profit from it, and it can increase also. So fixed capital, we can say that we have tools, machinery and buildings or the factories that we are working. So these are a fixed investment when a person is doing the factory, establishing a factory or industry. Tools, machines, buildings, these land, these are the fixed deposits. Then working of the raw material. Raw material is also comes in the physical capital, and raw material from which the goods have been manufactured or produced, it is very important. Then comes money used up in the process. Then money is plays very important and the crucial role starting up a business, farming or any non-farming activity. Money plays very important role in the production. So the things can be settled in each by money. Then human capital. Human capital means human resources. the people working for the activity, for the production in the fields or non-farming activities, industry, these people have knowledge and experience, and they have a enterprise to do their business, this work. So knowledge and experience comes, or their skill or their physical strength come in the human capital. So these are the factors: land, labor, physical capital, money, human capital are the factors of production.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.